Hi friends, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I wanted to talk about how I transitioned into data science without having a data science degree. I am a self-taught data scientist, and I wanted to specifically share my journey and highlight things that helped me in that journey to kind of transition to data science without having that degree. I'm a self-taught data scientist, and I've been in the industry for about 8 years now, and I worked at two big tech companies and have learned a lot over the years that I want to share with all of you. And one of the things that I thought it is important to mention is my journey and my transition from having no degree in data science to working at one of the biggest tech companies in the world. Let's go back a bit. So some of you probably came across my channel. So I started out at a community college, actually, because I was starting from scratch in a way. I am actually a high school dropout. The reasons I won't go into detail, but I have a 6-year gap between my high school and my university. So when I started all over again, I actually started at a community college, and I took 2 years of community college and took online classes at that community college for the first 2 years. And I was trying to, when I was trying to deciding to go back, my goal was to basically pursue a business degree, because that's what I was introduced to growing up. And I didn't know that data science job family existed, or people can actually work from their computers, which is mind-boggling to me. And I didn't grow up with the phone. I don't know if you did, but I did not grow up with a phone or a computer. Like, we didn't have a computer in our house, and people in my circle didn't work in tech, so like, I wasn't exposed to it. So that was one of the reasons when I decided to go back, I decided to pursue a business major. So when I went to the community college, I was basically preparing my portfolio, my course portfolio for a business degree. So that's what I ended up doing. Took a lot of like prerequisites for the business school, applied to the business school, got rejected, then got accepted, ended up making to University of Washington Business School as a transfer student. And it was actually my third year, well, my first year at University of Washington, but my third year of my undergrad degree, when I took a class at the business school. One of the things that my advisor told me was that take classes across all the majors that are offered within business school. And one of the majors was information systems. Not a major, I think minor, was information systems. So I ended up taking that class. And in that class, basically that class introduced me to databases, to SQL, to data analysis. And after I took that class, I realized like, this is it. That's exactly what I wanna do, and I wanna pursue a career in data. At that point, I still had no clue like data science is a job family that exists. I was just going after the data analysis and SQL and the database management type of courses. So I started taking like online courses in like databases, and started taking online courses in SQL, and trying to get more and more, because it was too late for me to change my major, because I was already in my third year. So I realized at that point, like, it's actually because given I had worked so hard to get into business school, I remember I mentioned that I was actually rejected and then I was accepted. So I had shed a lot of tears, and all the hard work was behind it, that I, honestly, like at that point I was like, do I really want to leave business school? Like, worked so hard to get here. But I ended, and like, that wasn't even a choice, because I was like so close to graduation. So I decided to like take a lot of courses, like reading through the online blogs, and I think W3 school was one of the big ones back then. I think it still is. So I started doing like a lot of like SQL practices on W3 schools, and explore some of the courses that are available on websites such as like Coursera and Udemy. So eventually I got more, the more I did it, the more I got interested in the field. And at this point, I still had no clue that data science job family exists. So I ended up doing internship at my last company, that internship was more focused on the financial analyst, that the title was financial analyst intern. So I did that internship, and I got exposed to a lot of people in the industry who were working as data engineers, as data scientists, and as a data analyst. And I networked a lot with those people during my time in the internship, and I kind of like talked to them, asked them questions, and kind of like figured out what I want to do eventually. The data engineering role seemed super interesting at that point. So after finishing my internship, even though like my team was asking me to come back as a financial analyst full time, I told them like, that's not what I want to do. So I ended up finishing my internship, went back to UW, and ended up taking a lot of courses that are more into database management. outside of business school. There was a school called iSchool, Information School. So I ended up taking a bunch of courses there. I remember the three courses that I did there. I'm going to link them in the description. It's a certificate. The three courses that I took, they're basically made up into a nice certificate. I'm going to link it in the description. The certificate, like, I got it later. So the reason I'm mentioning it, because like people, as soon as I mentioned I took the certificate, a lot of people want to take it. I got the certificate after I got my full-time offer. So my certificate wasn't like a influential, like having it on my resume wasn't like a big influence. The knowledge that I learned helped me pass the coding interviews. And those interviews, I actually landed through my networking, because when I was interning, I started networking outside of my team, specifically with people who are working in those roles that I want to get into. So eventually I landed myself a couple of interviews, and taking those courses kind of helped me prepare for the interview and gave me a really good understanding of how this whole data engineering world works. Eventually got offers from two different teams for the data engineering role. My team ended up finding out that I got an offer for a data engineering role. They finally decided to open a role that was specific, for a data engineer in the team, and they basically offered me a job. I decided to go with my internship team because I was already familiar with the people that worked there, and the people that worked there, as well as like the domain. I was pretty familiar with the area, with the data and everything. Got the full-time offer, finished my business degree, and transitioned into data engineer role. Worked there as a data engineer for 2 years. I enjoyed the data engineering process. I really enjoyed the building part of it. Like, I had physical things that I could point to, and I could also tell like how many people are using it. Let's say if I build a new table, I would know like how many people are accessing this table and how many people are using this table. And that way, like when it comes to like performance review and things like that, I was able to like mention those numbers specifically. And the reason I'm mentioning this, because it's important as to what I'm gonna say later after I transition to the data science job family. So at the end of the 2 years, I started feeling pretty comfortable with the data engineering job family, and I realized that I need to explore more within the data domain. Ended up doing a project for my team, the same team where I was working as a data engineer, more on the research and data analytics focus. And that was the point where I realized like I want to go more into like research focused projects in the data domain, and I want to go more into data sciencey role. Started my job search again. Basically, there was no opportunity in that team to transition to data science because there were no data scientists there. So I ended up talking to a lot of different teams at my last company, and found this one manager that I talked to. We had coffee, and then I told him basically like, this is what I want to do. Like, but because they needed a data engineer, but they were like a data scientist team. So I told my to-be manager at that time that this is what I'm interested in. I can join your team and I can provide a lot of the data engineering skill set. But while I'm doing that, I want to learn and I want to eventually transition to a data scientist role. The manager was amazing because he ended up taking me in. And basically I worked on a few data engineering projects at the beginning of my time there, but eventually I was given the opportunities to learn data science, and having teammates who have worked at that time in that team and data scientists in that team. So having teammates who have worked on data science work, I was able to learn from their work. I was able to like read their paper. I was able to go through their code repository and see like how they did it. So the next 6 months or so, I spent a lot of time like reading through their work. Then my manager would kind of like assign me reading, as in like books to read and things to kind of like look into more. And we'll use like our one-on-ones kind of like as like a learning session where I would ask questions, and then he will sometimes whiteboard or like point me to resources to kind of like learn. I give him a lot of credit because not all managers are like that. I think it's very rare to find a manager who is actually interested in growing your career and is willing to put time and energy to kind of like help you grow. So I got very lucky with that manager. And eventually I knew after a few months, I knew data science to an extent where I was given my own project and I was able to deliver it. Yes, there would be times where I was given projects, I would have to learn, and then I would have to come to work and apply it. So a lot of that processes where I was like just thrown into problem and where I had to learn and apply it, learn and apply. I think that did two things for me. One is that it kind of like put, Like, I didn't have an option other than to deliver, right? So, like, that created, like, a pressure setting for me. And I think, like, it depends from person to person. Some people don't like that environment. Like, I work very well when I'm on a deadline or when I'm given in, when I'm in an environment. I think there is a thrive in a fast-paced environment. Basically, that's what it means. Like, you work on a deadline and you work, like, very fast. I think I'm really good at that. Like, I like having a time-bound project because that pushes me to, like, do it. So I think having that on my projects was helpful because I had a deadline to deliver a project. The second, it kind of narrowed my learning because data science for job family is huge and you can get lost learning everything. And for me, like going project-based, with the project-based learning framework, I was able to narrow down things that I need to learn and then I apply it right away and that it sticks with me. I learned while doing it. So it was like perfect setting for me because I would learn those, whatever requirement would be for those project, and then I would learn and then I would apply and then it would stick with me because let's say next project, if it requires a similar set of skill set, let's say linear regression, if my second project requires linear regression, there's like less learning for me because I've already worked on it and I'm able to kind of do it. So eventually my manager, after building some portfolio of work, my manager ended up transitioning me to the data science job family. I didn't have like, as the title of this video says, I still don't have a data science degree. And when my manager put in that proposal, the HR actually had an issue with it because they said that she doesn't have a degree in data science and why are you transitioning her? Because a lot of the other people that I was working with, they had like PhDs and PhDs and masters in statistics and things like that. So my manager was, again, like he was a great manager again. He basically countered the HR and he said that if she can actually do the work, why do you care about having a check mark on the degree? And that did the trick because then ended up getting converted to the data scientist job family, ended up working. The team that I worked at that time was primarily focusing on building advanced statistics that could be used company-wide for A/B testing analysis and experimentation that were run being in the company. Ended up working there for about, in that same role, same team, until 3 years, until my manager that I really, really liked working with left. So after he left, I kind of like made that, I kind of like decided to like leave the team as well as the company because I wanted to try something different. So yeah, basically that was my transition from having no degree in data science to becoming a data scientist, working at one of the FAANG companies. So my advice to anybody who is trying to transition to data science, I think there's a lot of educational resources that are out there that if you are disciplined enough, you can create your own curriculum and you can kind of like create that path for you to like study in your own time and make that transition. But again, like the environment that I had, the opportunity that I had, I understand that not everybody gets it, but if you do get that opportunity, fully evangelize it. If you're working at a big company where you have the opportunity to pursue different roles and try out different things, like do that because that would be the least, like from money standpoint, that would be the least costly from the money standpoint because I did save a lot of money because I was getting paid while I was learning. But that being said, there are definitely a lot of resources out there, whether those are like programs such as master's program or undergrad program or boot camps or courses, the online courses that are available at your fingertips now, which I didn't have when I was trying to make that transition. And remember, I've been in the industry for about 8 years and data scientists job family only started becoming glamorous, I think, after the 2014 Harvard Business Review. So since then, there has been a lot of educational resources and like YouTube is one of them. There's so many amazing YouTubers who are talking about data science. And so evangelize all those resources that are available to you. But my biggest tip would be to actually apply it. I think it's very easy for us to get lost because there's so much to learn. Narrow down your focus. If you focus your learning to like project-based learning, let's say if you're trying to create a portfolio of data science work, if you figure out first like what projects you want to do, and then like curate your learning based off of those projects, I think that could help you narrow down your focus. Obviously, like, this is one of the frameworks that you can use. There are like so many frameworks that you can use to learn data science, and maybe I'll talk about it in a different video. So yeah, that's all I wanted to share. Thank you if you made it this far into the video, and I hope you're having a great day, and I hope you there was something that you learned from this, from my journey. I also want to talk, maybe I'll do it another video where I want to talk about community colleges and how my experience was, because I think there is a lot of glamorization of Ivy League schools and things like that. But I think the community colleges are like low hanging fruits, and I come from a community college, and I worked at two big tech companies. So they must be doing something right to create people like me who are able to like make it in the industry without having the Ivy League degrees. So I'll definitely do another video where I talk more in detail about that. So until then, I hope you're having a great day, and I'll talk to you in another video.